is given at given temperature. The energy of activation is also given in kilojoule per mole. These note the units. We have to find the pre-exponential factor in the Arrhenius equation. Correct. The equation we know is K is equal to A e to the power minus Ea by RT. T is given, R is something we know, Ea is given, A is something which you have to find, K is also given. Let's put the values. Right. So we have K is equal to A e to the power minus Ea by RT. Put ln both sides. Ln k is nothing but ln a minus Ea by RT. If you want to put log, you can do that also. Log k is equal to log a minus Ea by 2.303 RT. We know that ln to log, we have to take care of this 2.303 factor. We have to find A, so let's put log A on the left hand side. It's nothing but log K plus A by 2.303 RT. Let's put the values here. Log of K, K is given in per second, 2.418 into 10 to the power minus 5 plus EA. EA is given what? 179.9 kilojoule. So we have to convert into joule first, right? So that becomes 179.9 into 10 to the power 3 joule per mole. This becomes 179.9 into 10 to the power 3 joule per mole. Please note this has to be in joule per mole. Divide by 2.303. R is 8.314 and T is my temperature in Kelvin. That is 546. Right, this is in per second, and this also, if you see, it will come out to be in per second. You can actually solve it, okay? Because this is in Kelvin, this is joules per mole per Kelvin. This gets cancelled, joules per mole, joules per mole cancel. So, if you solve this. Log A is nothing but 12.5917, and A is nothing but anti log of this. It is nothing but 3.9 into 10 to the power 12 per second, and that is maths. Just mathematics, nothing great here. The question says decomposition of hydrocarbon follows this equation. We have to find the value of Ea. See, K is nothing but A e to the power minus Ea by RT. If you compare these two equations, e to the power coefficient, we can compare. So that is Ea by RT or minus Ea by RT, nothing but minus 2800 K by. This K is Kelvin, T is in temperature. We have to find E. Correct. So T, T gets cancelled, minus minus gets cancelled. Let's put the value of R. E is nothing but 2800 into R. Right? R is what? 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. And there is a K already there. K, K cancelled. You solve this, you get 232.792 joule per mole, and that is nothing but 232.792 kilojoule per mole, and that is correct unit of activation energy. Pretty easy. Just this formula, this looks similar to our formula, Arrhenius equation. Compare the formula and found the activation. The rate constant for the first order decomposition of H2O2 is given by the following equation. We have to find Ea for this reaction, and at what temperature will its half period will be 256 minutes. Two things we have to find here. First thing, we have to find the EA, activation energy. And the second thing we have to find, we are given the half period, T half. And we need to find at what temperature it will become. From T half, we can easily find K. Correct? 0.693 by K is T half. So that means we have the value of K, and we have to tell at what temperature that will be the value of K. And we know that the K value is changing with respect to temperature, and for that we have the RMS equation. So we can easily find the values. Correct? First, let's find the EA. So the equation we have is log K is 1.25 into 10 to the power 4 K by T. The equation we know is K is equal to A e to the power minus E by RT. It is all log, right? So if we put log in this equation, the equation we get is log K is equal to log A minus A by 2.303 RT. The equation they gave us is this equation. Let's put the value. Log K is equal to 14.34 minus 1.25 into 10 to the power 4 K by T. So we compare these two equations. Log A is this, and this part is same, right? This part is equal to this part. We compare these two. So from this I can say that EA by 2.303 RT is equal to 1.25 into 10 to the power 4 K by T. TT cancel. So EA is nothing but 2.303 into R, that is 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin into 1.25 into 10 to the power 4 K. Right? This gets cancelled. So when you solve this, you get 239339.3 units joule per mole. All you can get is 239.34 kilojoule per mole. So that is my activation energy that I have for. The next question is, at what temperature the T half will be 256 minutes. So till now we have found EA, right? So we have to find temperature at which T half is this. So temperature at which T half is 256 minutes, I can easily find the K. K is nothing but 0.693 by T half, and that is nothing but 0.693 by 256 minutes. I can make it in seconds. This is 4.51 into 10 to the power minus 5 per second. This is the K, and I have to find, I know the K, I have to find T. Correct? I know the K, I have to find T. I can easily find. Let's put the value in this equation. This equation, log K is equal to 14.34 minus 1.25 into 10 to the power 4 K by T. Just put the values here. So log K is what? Log of 4 point, this value. 51 into 10 to the power minus 5 per second. 1.34 minus 1.25 into 10 to the power 4 K by T. T is something you have to find, right? So if you solve this, actually T will come out to be 669 K. I'll not solve this for you, you can solve this on your own, because here this you can find a value, log of this, this is a constant, again subtract this, you get the value of T to be 669 K. One thing to note here is, when you're finding K, find it in seconds, because in this equation we use all the value of R, that is moles per liter per second, right? So the second get cancelled, so it has to be in seconds. These equations, we use all SI units, nothing in minutes, nothing in hours. So K has to be in seconds. If you find minutes, you'll be in trouble. It has to be in seconds. correct. The decomposition of A into product has K given at 10 degrees Celsius. Energy of activation is given. What would the temperature be if K is a new K? See, the formula we know is K is equal to A e to the power minus E A by RT. That is the formula we know. Correct. Let's put both log both sides. We get log K is equal to log A minus E by 2.303 RT. Why 2.303? Because if you use ln, there won't be any 2.303, but we are using log, we get this equation. So we have K for two different terms. This is K1 and this is K2. Right? Temperature is given T1. T2 is something we have to find. So let's put the value for case 1. Case 1, right? Log K1 equal to log A minus EA by 2.303 into R into T1. Case 2, log of K2 is nothing but log A minus A by 2.303 RT2. Equation 1, equation 2. Subtract these two equations, that log A will get cancelled. Subtract these two equations, you get log of K1 minus log of K2 is equal to A by 2.303 R. This becomes 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. This is what you will get. Now if you see in this formula, we have everything. We know K1, yes. We know K2, yes. We know activation energy, yes, it is in kilojoule per mole, we need to convert it to joules per mole. We know R, we know 8.314. We know T2, we have to find. T1, we know 10 degrees Celsius, that is nothing but 10 plus 273, that is 283 Kelvin, right? This is 6, this is joules per mole. So we know everything, we know only one, we don't know only one value. You put everything in this equation, now you can actually put it, right? This log K1 minus log K2, you can now also write log K1 by K2. That you can do it actually. So you just put all the values in this equation, because we have all the values in this equation except one value, that is my temperature T2. And when you put all the values, you get T2 as 297 Kelvin. And that is my answer. If you want in Celsius, you can make it 24 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this equation has all the parameters we know except T2. And T2 is something which we don't know.